हेलो गाइस, माय सेल्फ सोलंकी हिमानी एंड आई स्टडी इन गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज ऑफ नर्सिंग भावनगर। टुडे माय टॉपिक इज ग्लूकोमा। लेट्स स्टार्ट वी डिस्कस अबाउट ग्लूकोमा। फर्स्ट इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ ग्लूकोमा। ग्लूकोमा इज अ डिसीज ऑफ ऑप्टिक नर्व विच इज एसोसिएटेड विथ हाई प्रेशर इन साइड द आई। ग्लूकोमा इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड स्नीक थीफ ऑफ साइट बिकॉज मैनी पीपल रिमेन अनडायग्नोज्ड अंटिल इररिवर्सिबल विजन लॉस अकर्स। ग्लूकोमा रिफर्स टू अ ग्रुप ऑफ डिसीज कैरेक्टराइज्ड बाय ऑप्टिक न्यूरोपैथी एंड स्पेसिफिक पैटर्न ऑफ विजुअल फील्ड डिफेक्ट। मीन्स इन ग्लूकोमा टू सिम्टम्स इज प्रेजेंट, ऑप्टिक न्यूरोपैथी एंड स्पेसिफिक पैटर्न ऑफ विजुअल फील्ड लॉस और विजुअल फील्ड डिफेक्ट। इट इज़ सिम्टोमैटिक कंडीशन ऑफ द आई विच इज इंक्रीज इंट्रा ऑक्युलर प्रेशर। नॉर्मल इंट्रा ऑक्युलर प्रेशर इज 10 to 24 mmHg, बट इन ग्लूकोमा पेशेंट इंट्रा ऑक्युलर प्रेशर इज मोर देन 25। ग्रुप ऑफ डिसीज दैट डैमेज द ऑप्टिक नर्व एंड रिजल्टेंट विजुअल फील्ड लॉस विच कैन प्रोग्रेस टू ब्लाइंडनेस। गाइस, यू कैन सी दिस फिगर द डिफरेंस बिटवीन नॉर्मल आई एंड ग्लूकोमा आई। इन ग्लूकोमा आई ऑप्टिक नर्व डैमेज एंड इंक्रीज इंट्राऑक्युलर प्रेशर इन द विट्रस कैविटी एंड ट्रबेक्युलर मेजर वाइड देन बिल्डअप ऑफ एक्वियस ह्यूमर फ्लूड एंड देन इंक्रीज इंट्राऑक्युलर प्रेशर। Next, what is glaucoma? Then definition of glaucoma. Glaucoma is a group of ocular conditions characterized by optic nerve damage related to increased intraocular pressure caused by congestion of aqueous humor in the eye. Means in glaucoma, three characteristics is present: increased intraocular pressure, optic nerve damage, and visual field loss. Guys, you can see this figure. In glaucoma eye drainage channel and normal eye drainage channel. In glaucoma, the eye drainage channel is blocked, and normal drainage channel. And next figure, you can see changes in the optic nerve and pressure buildup in the vitreous cavity. Next, we discuss about the types of glaucoma. Glaucoma has three to four types: close angle glaucoma, open angle or acquired glaucoma, then congenital glaucoma and absolute glaucoma. Open angle glaucoma or acquired glaucoma have two subtypes: primary angle glaucoma and secondary open angle glaucoma. Then congenital glaucoma is also divided three subtypes: true congenital glaucoma, infantile congenital glaucoma, and juvenile congenital glaucoma. First, we discuss about the close angle glaucoma. In close angle glaucoma, it occurs when iris bulges forward to narrow or block the drainage formed by the cornea and iris. Then fluid can't circulate through eye and pressure increase. You can see this slide. In lens and cornea between space is decreased and trabecular meshwork is widely open and intraocular pressure is increased, then close angle glaucoma produce. Next is acquired glaucoma. In acquired glaucoma is leads to acquired condition is called acquired glaucoma. And acquired glaucoma divide other two subtypes. First is primary acquired or primary open angle glaucoma, is also called as a chronic open angle glaucoma, chronic simple glaucoma, and glaucoma simplex. It is most common type of glaucoma. It is usually bilateral with insidious onset and slowly progressive course without discomfort or pain. It is produced by overproduction or aqueous humor through trabecular meshwork, then increased intraocular pressure and damaged optic nerve. Next subtype of acquired glaucoma is secondary glaucoma. It refers to any form of glaucoma in which there is an identifiable cause of increased eye pressure resulting damage optic nerve and vision loss. Third type is congenital glaucoma. Congenital glaucoma is rare amount of seen in people. Congenital glaucoma occurs when congenital defect in angle of anterior chamber obstruct the outflow of aqueous humor. Congenital glaucoma is less prevalent than acquired glaucoma. It is most cases surgery is required. Congenital glaucoma have three subtypes, guys. We discuss about slide, and first type is true congenital glaucoma. True congenital glaucoma is labeled when intraocular pressure raised during intrauterine life and child is born with ocular enlargement. Occurrence about 40% of cases. Means this type of congenital glaucoma is mostly seen in child or newborn babies. Next is infantile congenital glaucoma. It is labeled when disease manifests prior to child's third birthday. It occurs in about 50% of cases. Infantile glaucoma is after birth and third year of the baby. In 50% cases in glaucoma in 50% cases is infantile glaucoma. Next is juvenile glaucoma. Juvenile glaucoma is labeled in the rest 10% of cases, which develop pressure rise between 3 to 16 years of the life. And last and final types is absolute glaucoma. It is the last stage of glaucoma. In this type, four characteristics is seen: absence of pupillary light reflex, pupillary response, eye has no vision, and severe pain is present in the eye. So if absolute glaucoma you cannot proper treatment, then you lost your vision loss. Next is causes and risk factor of glaucoma. First, genetics, family history of glaucoma means in fact glaucoma is a hereditary disease. Aging means if age increase, then glaucoma chances is increased. Hypertension, severe myopia means nearsightedness, you cannot see the near object. Eye trauma, ocular surgery, diabetes mellitus, migraine headache, prolonged use of corticosteroid, emotional excitement due to external pressure on the eye. Next, sign and symptoms of glaucoma. Close angle glaucoma pain, blur vision or vision loss. If blur vision but you can not proper treatment and not cure the glaucoma, then last stage you gain vision loss. Rainbow halos around the light, nausea, vomiting, loss of peripheral vision, headache, photophobia, and failure to detect color changes. Next is pathophysiology of glaucoma. If another etiological factor, then structural alteration in aqueous outflow, functional alteration in eye, optic nerve damage, increase intraocular pressure, and vision loss. In this pathophysiology through we called about in outer environmental or other causes and risk factor through the alteration in the functional or structural changes in the eye and optic include optic nerve damage, increase intraocular pressure in the vitreous body, and trabecular measure quietly open and aqueous humor fluid is more amount in the eye, then last vision loss. Diagnostic evaluation. How to diagnose the glaucoma? First, we take patient's ocular and medical history, because glaucoma is a one cause is family history. Then ophthalmoscopy is also called funduscopy. It is examination of fundus of the eye through ophthalmoscope. Next, fundus photography, and last is loss of peripheral vision. Another diagnosis evaluation is through tonometry. Tonometry is a diagnostic tool. The tonometry is gently pressed against the eyeball, and resistance means internal pressure is measured. This required that the eye be numbed prior to test. Means in tonometry through we measure the internal pressure of the eye. Next is gonioscopy. Gonioscopy can be used to determine if the angle where the iris meets the cornea is open or closed. Means gonioscopy through which we measure the open and closed angle glaucoma. Next is perimetry. Perimetry is an essential method used to determine if there is any loss of visual field. Means in perimetry through we check about the visual our visual power. Next is slit lamp. Slit lamp examination is another method of diagnosis of patient with suspected glaucoma. Last is management of the glaucoma. First, medical management. In medical management, gives beta adrenergic blocker like Timorous, Metoprolol, Metoprolol, Timolol, etc. Beta adrenergic blocker is decrease aqueous humor production. Next, cholinergic agent. Cholinergic agent like pilocarpin, caracalla, carbacol, etc. Cholinergic agent is decrease intraocular pressure by facilitating the outflow of aqueous humor. Next, carbonic anhydride inhibitor like acetazolamide. At carbonic anhydride inhibitor decrease formation and secretion of aqueous humor. Next, adrenergic agonist like epinephrine. It is decrease intraocular pressure by improving aqueous humor outflow. And last is osmotic agent like mannitol or glycerin. It is decrease intraocular pressure by creating osmotic pressure gradient between blood and intraocular fluid. Next is surgical management of glaucoma. First, argon laser trabeculoplasty. In this method used to that open angle glaucoma, burn the blockage of trabecular meshwork through laser and open the intratrabecular space, thereby increase the outflow of aqueous humor and decrease intraocular pressure. Argon laser trabeculoplasty is a use in open angle glaucoma, and this method through we burn the trabecular meshworks blockage part which is not enter the aqueous humor in the cavity, then in decrease intraocular pressure. Next is laser iridotomy. It is first line treatment in close angle glaucoma. In this procedure, opening is made by the laser beam in the iris to eliminate the pupillary block, and it promotes the outflow of the aqueous humor. Laser iridotomy is mostly used in close angle glaucoma. And in this procedure, aqueous humor flow promote and block the pupillary. Next, silo cryotherapy. In this method, apply the freezing probe to the sclera and destroy some of the ciliary process. Results reduce the aqueous humor fluid produced. Next, filtering procedure. In filtering procedure, two types: ocular implantation and trabeculectomy. Ocular implantation is in this procedure control the flow of aqueous humor, and trabeculectomy means remove part of the trabecular meshwork. And last is nursing management. Nursing management is divided to preoperative and postoperative care. First, we discuss about preoperative care. In preoperative care, obtain the client's history, then review planned surgery, complete physical assessment, and describe and explain pre-admission treatment and diagnostic test, then interpret diagnostic test. Provide time for the client and significant others to ask question and voice concern, and discuss post-operative discharge plan to patient and relatives. Next is post-operative care. In post-operative, avoid health education to patient and relatives to avoid coughing and sneezing, straining, etc., because which is increase the intraocular pressure. Assess post-operative pain, assess surgical complication, health education for home care, instruction to patient and relatives, the patient should be recommended position in the bed or as his condition necessitates. Instruct the client not to lie on opposite side to avoid pressure on the surgical side. Next, assess nausea, vomiting and other complication. Follow-up care, monitor for delay healing and any other condition. You can follow up to the doctor or your physician. Thank you so much, guys. Please like, share and subscribe our channel.